In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to jazz up your text animation with some fancy tricks. Text animation makes your video stand out and command attention. There are links in the description for the project file, template, ways you can keep this channel alive, my affiliates, and the School of AE. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Command or Control T to bring up your text tool. I'm just going to type in here, text animation. We're going to be pre-comping this. It doesn't really matter what the text is. You can always change it later, and this will be a procedural animation. So whenever you update your text, it will update on your animation. Go to your effects and presets and type in lock anchor. We want to add a lock anchor point. This comes native in After Effects as of 2023. P to bring up our position. Option click on the stopwatch for position and type in value, comma, open bracket, 960, comma, 540. And so what that's going to do is put our text right in the middle of our composition there. If I wanted to make something like 7 minute AE, it stays right in the middle of our text animation. Shift command C to pre-comp this. 01 underscore position underscore stroke fill PC for pre-comp. And now that we've pre-comped that, let's go ahead and name this composition. Let's say 02, position, stroke, fill. The reason why I'm doing this is because we're going to save this as a template. So whenever you bring this back into another project, you'll know that you start here on 01 for this pre-comp, and 02 is going to be the actual animation. Press P for position, put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation, and shift page down twice to go for 20 frames. Put down another keyframe there. Go back to this first keyframe, and let's just move this out of view. I'm going to take the second keyframe and F9 to make that easy ease. Go to the graph editor and pull that handle over. So that way what we have is this. At the second keyframe, if we select position, just a word position, notice it highlights both of these keyframes. So now I can move this on the X or Y axis and it will move both keyframes. So I'm going to go up to 340 because our center point is 540 and I'm going to go 200 pixels above our center point. And then we're going to take this layer and duplicate that. Again, I'm going to press position to make sure these keyframes are selected and move this down to 740. We have one layer that's 200 pixels above the midpoint and one layer that's 200 pixels below. I also want to take this first keyframe and come back in the opposite direction. So we watch that play back. We can see they come in from two different directions. Select both of these and hit U to bring up our keyframes. Now from the second keyframe, page down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Put another keyframe there and then shift page down 1, 2 to go forward 20 frames. Make both of these Y values 540. And then we want to select this third set of keyframes here. Go back to our graph editor and let's pull these all the way to the right. So what we have is this. And again, since this is pre-comped, if we were to change this text, say Jeff Knight, go back out to our main comp, we can see that it updates automatically. So that's kind of the cool part about pre-comping this is that you can change your text and the animation will update. Command Option Y to create an adjustment layer, rename this color control. Right click on color control, go to effect, expression controls, color control. Call this color 1. And then we can duplicate that twice. So command or control D 1, 2 times. And these colors can obviously be anything. I'm going to select some colors here just for illustration purposes. But again, you can make this whatever you want. So our top layer here, I'm going to rename this fill and then rename this second one stroke. And I'm going to give them two different colors. Okay, so fill will make yellow, stroke will make orange. Fill layer, right click, effect, generate, fill. It can be any color for now because we are going to link this up to our color control. Okay, and then for our stroke layer, we're going to do something a little bit different. Okay, so let's move our playhead somewhere about right here so that way we can see both of these layers. Now, right click on the stroke layer, go to layer styles, and we're going to select stroke. Again, this can be any color because we're going to be connecting this to our color control. I just want this layer to show a stroke. And the way you can do that is to open up your blending options, advanced blending, reduce your fill opacity down to nothing. So now we have a stroke and we have a fill. Okay, and I do want to make another change to this stroke here. As you can see, you have these options for outside, inside, and center. I want this to be inside, so that way when these lay on top of each other, the stroke disappears. So see, if this is on outside, which is what it defaults to, our stroke is on the outside of our fill. We don't want that. We want it to be on the inside. Select color control, and we want to lock that down by pressing this padlock right there. Select fill and color layers. and then go to our finder and just type in color. Pick whip our fill color up to color 1, and then our stroke color also up to color 1. And so now these are both white. And I also want to make one more change. Let's go back into our stroke layer here. I'm going to make my stroke size 2 instead of 3, so that way it's not quite as thick. Select both layers, Command or Control D, 1-2 times, so that way we have 3 copies of each. Go forward 3 frames and move our second iteration of fill and stroke to that by putting our playhead at the 3-frame mark and hitting left bracket. Go forward another 3 frames to 6. Choose this bottom fill layer and left bracket, bottom stroke layer, left bracket. So what we have is this. Let's select all of these layers. I already have the word color in our finder, so I'm just going to hit return to bring up color on all of these. Our first layers here, we've already connected those. So for the second fill color, I'm going to go up to color 2. And same thing for the third, bring this up to color 3. And then same thing for our strokes. So the second stroke color, we're going to go up to color 2. And for the third stroke, we're going to use our pick whip and up to color 3. Now make sure you're using this pick whip right here, okay? Not this one. This one is for our layer. This one is for our color. So now if we watch this playback, we get something that looks a little bit more interesting. And I may make that blue a little bit lighter so that way it kind of pops a little bit better. Now, one of the things I normally like to do is turn on my motion blur. So if we turn that on. Now, one of the things you will notice on the stroke layers, we get this weird kind of deforming here. And that's because we're using a layer style stroke. And layer styles don't work too well with motion blur. I'm going to take off these motion blurs. Command Option Y to create another adjustment layer. Motion blur. Go to our effects and presets and type in force. The only thing that will pop up is this force motion blur. I'm going to double click on that. And now we have motion blur on these layers, but we don't get that weird deforming on that stroke layer. Now, the only thing about using force motion blur is it is kind of heavy and it's going to slow down your animation a little bit. One of the things you could do is put your force motion blur above your strokes and then turn on the motion blur on your fill layers. So that way this motion blur is only applying to your stroke layers. The fill layers are fine. They don't have any weird deforming, but your stroke layers do. And that may just kind of speed it up just a little bit. So I'm going to turn off our motion blur for now and hide this right here. We can make changes to this color control. Let's go back over to our color control. Make sure you unlock this whenever you're not on it. I just noticed that mine was still locked. That's why I had 2 instances of effects controls panel. So I'm going to go ahead and change these colors. Maybe I'll make the second one like an orange and maybe the third one more like a green. I hope this helped you out. Leave me a message in the comments below and let me know if this is the kind of thing you'd like to see. As always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.